Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Blessings to all of you. So, sometimes when we want to help somebody, it is not working very well, right? And we have to understand one thing, and this is that every one of us is born as a king in his kingdom. You are a king in your kingdom. And first of all, you have to learn to take care for your own kingdom. But when you do not realize that you are a king in your kingdom, you have might be the tendency to go into another one's kingdom and try to arrange the kingdom of somebody else. And this usually doesn't work well, you know. In the worst case, you can become dependent of the kingdom of somebody else. And you can become a slave, you can become somebody that is not you. And that happens very often with people, that they have little self-confidence, that they have little self-trust, no? Because a king needs to be in truth. And this is why the truth is so important, to follow truth, to develop truth in yourself, to develop a righteous life, no? And when you can do that, when you are in this righteousness, when you are in the straight path, you feel that your kingdom comes into order. And that is how you become conscious, actually, about your own kingdom. And if you don't do that, if you run always into the lives of others, wanting to know what is going on in their lives, wanting to know what's going on in their relationships, wanting to know everything more than you want to know about yourself, then you create troubles, you know? And one of the consequences is that people may start to talk bad about you because you are too much interfering in the life of others. So mind your own business is a very, very great wisdom. And it's not easy for us because all our senses, all our energies drive us outside, and they drive us also to others. So to stay away from this temptation, to always think about other people's life, is not an easy thing, but it makes a leader a good leader. And to develop that consciousness that you are the king in your kingdom and you are born as you are supposed to be. Yeah? The sun is there, it is not something that you have to develop, actually. You don't have to become somebody. You have only to remember who you are already, because that is the game. We forget about ourselves, and we just remember our desires, our needs, and our traumas. And this is what we consider as our personality. This is why the word person, persona, means mask. This is the reason. What does it mask? It masks your sun. It masks yourself, your higher self. So when you can heal some of the aspects of the wounds, no? When you stop looking, always referring to the past, when you stop looking to the future also as well, that you are only future-oriented, but you allow this now, this being in your kingdom requires to be in the now. Yeah, otherwise you cannot be a king, no? Because the king is not in another time, it is now, and he's happy. And this is the most important thing, he's happy what he has or what she has, He's not looking for more. He's not looking to expand, for example, his kingdom, or to minimize the kingdom of others. He's not doing that. Yeah. And in this way, he lives a very harmonious life. No. So you can see what happens now in our world when somebody thinks that his kingdom is too small. Yeah. Then such a person goes and might be so hungry that there is no limit. On the other hand, we need also to understand why somebody does something. And of course we can say such a person is crazy, such a person is just an ego maniac, but rarely that is the case if someone is very long in power. Yeah, there must be something else. If someone is just a crazy one, he will not manage to stay long in power. Yeah, so there must be something else, and this something else needs to be understood. Our purpose on earth is, beside knowing ourselves, is that we do everything to come in peace with ourselves. Because up to now we cannot do it, we cannot live 1 second on this earth without killing each other. This is a very low level. Actually, it's the lowest level you can have, because what is below that level? We kill ourselves, it means we kill each other every second. There is not a second, imagine that. Yeah? We're not talking about a minute, we're not talking about hours, we're not talking about days or months or years. We talk about every moment. Yeah. Somebody is harmed every moment physically. Yeah. Killed physically. Okay. This is a very low, low level. They cannot be lower than that. And as a consequence of that, of course, everything suffers. And we are cut off from our own body, which is Earth. No? When we are too much in our needs, we do not understand what, for example, the garden around us needs. Yeah, we cannot take for our garden, we cannot take care for our garden. Earth is our garden. It feeds us, it protects us, it gives us everything. And if we don't understand that, the garden can be as rich as it wants to be, but finally it comes to an end. And this will be a horrible end. Because we have been told thousands and thousands and thousands of years, take good care. Take good care for yourself, strive as much as you can to be a good person, to be a righteous person, to be on the straight path. No, forgive people, be thankful, and so on and so on. It's thousands of years we hear it. And we hear also, take good care for people, for other people, for the elders. Listen to them, what the elders say. Take good care for your parents. Also try to honor them, no? And a person who does that has individually a happy life, but he cannot manage everything. Yeah. So we need more people. We need now all people, actually, to somehow wake up and take care for the garden, take care for themselves. If not, we run in heavy times. And of course, what happens, it shows us something, it shows us this aggression we all carry in us. If we would be free from aggression, no war can manifest, this is clear, right? So we have to work on our own aggression to pacify the situation. If everyone does that now, yeah, like with real effort, with real focus, yeah, we try to live every day at less conflict level as possible, then we will be all right. This is the whole thing. So attacking the enemy, attacking and trying to bring them down, is not really very wise, because this enemy is too strong. So what you do when the enemy is too strong, you give him something, where he can keep his face, where he can keep his reputation. If you try to destroy the reputation of somebody, you go on the bones of his life. And in that moment, such a person will become wild. Yeah. So when we are in front of a very big enemy, which is the case in this matter, we should not try to destroy the name of that person or to destroy the person. Yeah. This is never a good thing. You don't do that. You don't make things personal. And the moment you make it personal, it comes back. It comes back. And Eckhart Tolle said this very nice thing. No, he said, if your mindset is based on war, is based on these activities, you create the evil. And even you can defeat one evil, you will another worse evil than that will stand up. And this is what happens, you see. So really, this is the time where we rather should calm down and accept. And like this, we can minimize the damages for the people who are innocent, children, women, elder people, and all these people there, instead of firing the situation up, right? But we have this weapon of prayers, we have that weapon. This is a strong weapon, but the weapon will be not working if we are still ourselves in this aggression mode. Yeah. And every time something big happens, you find immediately two parties. This is not a good sign. Yeah. That means either there's people who act out of fear, who speak out of fear, no? And saying the end of the world is coming and God knows what is coming. Yeah. Or you have the others, they say, yeah, this man is completely true. He's on the right point, you know. No. There is a saying in our tradition, if you choose a party, yeah, especially those things, when something happens big, bigger than us, and you choose a party, you become the victim of this party. Yeah. So it's not about choosing a party. It is about always seeing first yourself and trying to correct. And when you can do that, you will be respected. Yeah, you will be respected. And this is what it needs. Respect can never go. Once we start to disrespect people and to demonize them, we shouldn't do that, because nothing in this field, no one in this field has the authority to do it. Not the West, not the East. They cannot teach each other. This is not their authority. They all made equally bad things. So, it's the time we need to find new ways to communicate and to learn to always see our own nose first. So, I hope you are doing well and you are healthy, and this is a testing time for us, and they look how much agitated we are, how much identified we are, no? So don't bring this conflict in your heart, that's not good. Yeah, leave it where it is. Pray for these people. If you can donate something that you feel safe with this donation, do it. This will be helpful for those people who are on the run. And when they come to our places, try to be gentle, not to fear that they take work from us or they are a burden for us. No, no. Yeah. This is the time now to show humanness, no? Thank you very much. Have blessed days, and may Allah protect all of us and forgives us. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Blessings to all of you.